ಅನುದಿನ ಅನುಕ್ಷಣ ಮನೆಯಲ್ಲೂ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ಕಲಿಕೆಯ ಹೊಸ ಹಾದಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಜೊತೆಗೂಡಿ ಹೆಜ್ಜೆಯ ಹಾಕೋಣ ಸಂತಸದಿ ಕಲಿಯೋಣ ನಮ್ಮ ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯಾಯಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ
ಎಸ್ ಸರ್
ಎಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್
ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್
Hi children, welcome to the English class of 8th standard, third language. I hope you all are ready with your belongings. Yes, textbook, pen, pencil and notebook. Now, here is an activity for you where you have to look at the pictures and match the category. Focus on the pictures. Yeah. The pictures of same category have been given for you. You have to look at these pictures and you have to match them. See, you can see, yes, fork, moon, mask, pot, wig, knife. You have to match according to the categories. You can also focus on words that are given with pictures. Yeah, most of you have done, I think. Okay. Yes. You are matching fork with knife. Moon with star. Mask with wig. Now, what you have matched the pictures are right. Now, let us see. Let us associate the words of the pictures what you have matched. Okay, children? Yes. Fork and knife. Toothbrush. Yes. Moon and star. Teapot. Mask and wig. Newspaper. Okay, children. Toothbrush, teapot, newspaper. In the earlier, there were two different words. Now, after matching, they have become one word, isn't it? Yes, these words are called compound words. Let us see the definition of compound words and many examples of it. Listen carefully. Compound words. These are the words formed by joining two words. These are the words formed by joining two words. Example, hand plus bank, handbag. Sun plus light, sunlight. Water plus proof, waterproof. Yeah, they are called compound words. You know, children, there may be one or more compound words for one word. There may be one or more compound words for one word. Example, motorbike. Yes, motor car, motorcycle, motor boat. Using the word motor, we can make many compound words. That is motorbike, motor car, motorcycle and motor boat. Compound words are formed by joining two words. Do, dusre alfazon ko mila ke jo naya alfaz banta hai, usse hum kya kehte hai? Compound words. I think you got the idea. Now, it's time for your work. On page number 23, in your textbook, they have given an activity for you. Use the following words and make compound words. There you can see the words. Here you can see the words. By looking at these words, yeah, you have to make the compound words using the words. Okay, children, it is on page number 23. Take your pencils. I'll read out the words for you. Later, we will go one by one. Okay. Pen, book, machine, moon, sun, head, man, stream, house. Okay, children. Once again, I'll read it. Pen, book, machine, moon, sun, head, man, stream, house. Okay. There is a mistake in the word stream, or it should not come. Okay. Let's manage. No issue. Okay, fine, children. Now, I think you have done the work there. Pen, pen man. Book, book stall. Machine, machine gun. Moon, moonlight. Sun, sunlight. Head, headmaster. Man, mankind. Steam, steamboat. Now here it is right. Steam, steamboat. House, housewife. Okay, now let us move on to the new words. We all know whenever the new words come, what we will do? First we will understand the simpler meaning of the particular word. Later we will use that word in a sentences. Okay. Here in a blue color you can see that preach. Preach means teach. Deliver a sermon. Preach means to teach or to deliver a sermon is said to be a preach. Shall we make the usage of the word preach in the following sentences? Very good, children. The mother has preached the value of good education. The mother has always preached the value of good education. Next, he preached frequently in the churches. Let us move to the next word, holy. Look at the word holy. Holy means religious importance. Holy means religious importance. H-O-L-I. H-O-L-I means, that is festival. H-O-L-Y means it is a religious important. Okay. We should visit holy places. We should visit holy places like temple, mosque, churches, dargah, basadis, viharas. Isn't it, children? We should visit all sorts of holy places. Then, let us see the usage of holy in one more sentence. Ramadan is the holy month for Muslims. Ramadan is the holy month for Muslims. Okay, let us move to the third one. Forefathers. Forefathers means ancestors. Forefathers means ancestors. Ancestors means our past grandfathers. My father's 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 father's. Yeah, it is known as forefathers, that is ancestors. Okay. My forefathers were merchants. My forefathers were merchants. This bungalow was built by our forefathers. This bungalow was built by our forefathers. You can see here. Okay. Okay, fine, children. Now, let us move to the text. Look at the screen. Please do not divert your mind. Look at the screen. Listen carefully. Focus on the pronunciation. Okay. Nanak traveled far and wide to preach his message of love. He visited many holy places. At Haridwar, he saw a large crowd of people bathing in river Ganges, some of them pouring water towards the sun. What are you doing? Nanak asked them. We are offering water to our forefathers they replied. Then see here, what are they? Sorry, where are they? Asked Nanak. They are in heaven, replied one of them. Where is the heaven? Asked Nanak. Crores of miles away, replied an old man in the crowd. Then, on hearing this, Nanak turned his back and started pouring water in other direction. What are you doing? Asked the people in surprise. I have my fields in Punjab, replied Nanak. I am watering those fields. People began to laugh. How can this water reach your fields far away? They asked. Then the water you throw up can reach heaven. Why can't water I throw reach my field? Asked Nanak. Then he explained to the people, it is only through good actions of ours that we can do honor to our forefathers. There are many such stories about Nanak. His method of teaching was very simple. People could follow his teaching very easily. Okay, children, once again, listen to the text. Okay, now you go word by word. Okay, I'll read it out for you. Nanak traveled far and wide to preach his message of love. He visited many holy places. At Haridwar, he saw a large crowd of people bathing in the river Ganges. Some of them pouring water towards the sun. What are you doing? Nanak asked them. We are offering water to our forefathers, they replied. Where are they? Asked Nanak. They are in heaven, replied one of them. Where is heaven? Asked Nanak. Crores of miles away, replied an old man in the crowd. On hearing this, Nanak turned his back and started pouring water in the other direction. What are you doing? Asked the people in surprise. I have my fields in Punjab, replied Nanak. I am watering those fields. People began to laugh. How can these water reach your fields far away? They asked. The water you throw up can reach heaven. Why can't water I throw reach my fields? Asked Nanak. Then he explained to the people, it is only through our good actions of us that we can do honor to our forefathers. There are many such stories about Nanak. His method of teaching was very simple. People could follow his teaching very easily. Children, now let us comprehend the text what we have read so far. Shall we? Okay, fine. See, you can see. Who are there in the picture? Mardana, Guru Nanak and Bala. Yeah, Mardana was a good singer. Nanak started writing his ideas into the poems. Later poems were changed into the songs of gods. Daily Mardana and Guru Nanak used to sing them. Bala, a peasant, he became their follower, isn't it, children? Next, what happened? Yeah, the all men and people were started to listen to their songs, and they made those songs of God as their daily prayers. Later, Nanak started to travel far and wide places. At Haridwar. See, Haridwar. In Haridwar, it is a tradition that we do some rituals for our peace, isn't it? We do some rituals. Our grandparents, our parents, they used to go for Haridwar to do the rituals which has come from our forefathers, isn't it? Likewise, you can see many people in Haridwar, they are doing their rituals. Nanak went there and he saw in Haridwar the people were pouring the water towards the sun. Yes, see here? Yeah, in Haridwar we know river Ganges flow. In that day, the peoples were offering the rituals. The people were pouring the waters towards the sun. Nanak saw and asked the people, "What are you doing?" Nanak asked, "What are you doing?" People said, "We are offering the water to our forefathers." "Where are they?" Nanak asked. He said, "They are in the heaven." "Where is the heaven?" Again Nanak asked, "Where is the heaven?" He said, "It is crores of miles away. Heaven is the crores of miles away from Haridwar." Then what Nanak did, you know? The Nanak, suddenly he turned back. And he started pouring the water. Then the people, the people are pouring that side and Nanak, he is pouring this side. Yes, people are pouring the water towards the sun and Nanak is pouring water in the opposite direction of the sun. Then one of the man in a crowd asked, "What are you doing?" "I am pouring water to the fields which are in Punjab." Nanak said, "I am pouring the water to my fields which are in Punjab," said Nanak. Then one of the men, "How it is possible? Haridwar is here and Punjab is so far, isn't it? How is this possible?" One of the men, he asked in a crowd. At that time, Nanak explained them that, when you are pouring the water to the forefathers who are there in the heaven, if your water can reach the heaven, why can't the water what I am pouring to my fields, why can't it reach to Punjab? He asked like that. Then people thought for a while. Later, very good words, Nanak said to the people, "If you want to do honor to your forefathers, just you do the good actions. Whatever the good actions we do, it will be a great and best honor to our forefathers who are in the heaven." Later, all the peoples began to follow the teachings of Guru Nanak. Children, there are many such stories related to Guru Nanak. The teachings of Guru Nanak were very simple and they are very interesting. So you should also watch these stories. You watch these stories in YouTube channels. There are many stories in YouTube channels. Okay, children? Okay, let me check your comprehension. Who visited to many holy places? Yes, Nanak visited to many holy places. Where did Nanak has his fields? Nanak had his fields in Punjab. Okay, children. Now, here is an activity for you on page number 20. Fine, children. Choose the appropriate words and complete the sentences. On page number 20, you can see the activity. Choose the appropriate words and complete the sentences. First, I read out words which are in bracket. Here, they are in green color. Worldly pleasures, forefathers, strange, humorous, poisonous, fierce, pleased. Yeah, we have already come across these words, isn't it? Yes, example. I will read out the first example which has given in a textbook too. Buddha renounced the worldly pleasures and left home in search of truth. Buddha renounced the worldly pleasures and left home in search of fruit. Now, I will read out rest of the sentences and be ready with the answers. There was a dash battle between Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi and the British. There was a dash battle between Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi and the British. This property belongs to our dash. This property belongs to our dash. Not all snakes, but only some are dash. Not all snakes, but only some are dash. Sneha enjoys dash stories. The man looked very dash because of dress he was wearing. The man looked very dash because of dress he was wearing. I think you are ready with your answers. Let us look into them. Okay, already we had gone through this. Buddha renounced the worldly pleasures and left home in search of truth. There was a fierce battle between Rani Lakshmibai of Jhansi and the British. Fill the word fierce in the first blank. Let us move to the second one. This property belongs to our forefathers. This property belongs to our forefathers. Fill it with the word forefather. Not all snakes, but only some are poisonous. Yeah. Sneha enjoys humorous stories. The man looked very strange because of dress he was wearing. Yeah, third with poisonous, fourth with the humorous, and fifth with strange. Okay, children. Then, match the following. You are all familiar with these characters, isn't it? Quickly, you can do this. First, I'll read out the characters which are in black color, okay, and which are in number also. Bala, Mardana, Metakalu, Nanak, Nanaki, and let us see what were their role. Okay. A singer. Nanak's sister. A peasant. Nanak's father. Nanak's brother. The first guru of Sikhs. Okay. I think no need of repetition here because you all are familiar with the characters. Okay. Bala. Very good children. A peasant. Mardana. A singer. Metakalu. Nanak's father. Nanak, the first guru of Sikhs. Nanaki, Nanak's sister. Good children, I think you, whatever the answers you have guessed and whatever the answers you were shouting were right. Once again, Bala, a peasant. Mardana, he was a singer. Metakalu, yes, Nanak's father. Nanak, the first guru of Sikhs, and Nanaki, Nanak's sister. Okay, children, you just repeat after me. Bala, a peasant. Mardana, a singer. Metakalu, Nanak's father. Nanak, the first guru of six. Nanaki, Nanak's sister. And one more activity. You are familiar with this. Who am I? See, it is also in your textbook. Yeah. Find the words and fill in the missing letters to get the right answer. Yeah, with the clue of those missing letters, with the clue of a sentence, you have to find the word and you have to write the letter which is missing here. Okay, children? Example is given for you. I argue in the court to get justice to people. We all know. Who argues in the court to get the justice to people? Already answer is there here. Yeah, lawyer. The spell of lawyer is L-A-W-Y-E-R. L-A-W-Y-E-R. Okay, now I will read all the sentences. All the words, sentences what here they have given. I entertain people in the circus. I entertain people in the circus. I perform on stage. I write novels. I till the land to grow crops. I teach in a college. Look here, children. I entertain people in the circus. J has been given with two blanks and ER, isn't it? Again, I perform on a stage. It starts from letter A. A dash, T dash, ST. I write novels. N dash, V dash, L dash dash, T. I till the land and grow crops. F dash, dash, M dash, R. I teach in a college. P dash, O F dash dash, S E R. See, I spell out one letter for you. Oh, still most of you have done. No problem with that. Few of them, they are not getting, I think. See, with the help of the pictures, you can recognize. Shall we move further the answers? Good, children. I entertain people in the circus. Joker. J-O-K-E-R. I perform on stage. Artist. A-R-T-I-S-T. I write novels. Novelist. N-O-V-E-L-I-S-T. I till the land and grow crops. A farmer. F-A-R-M-E-R. I teach in a college. Professor. P-R-O-F-E-S-S-O-R. Good, children. All of you have done the activity very effectively. Very good, children. Now it's time for assignment. Read the text. Whatever we have done today, from the beginning you read the text. And one more activity for you. On page 22, complete the activity B. On page 22, you have to complete the activity B. Arrange the sentences in a sequential order and write a paragraph. Related to the lesson, there are sentences. You have to arrange in a sequential order and you have to write a paragraph. I hope you all have enjoyed the class. This is your teacher, B.B. Sahira, GHPS Lachanakeri, Koppal Taluk and District. Okay, children. Bye-bye. Take care.
Anudina, anukshana, maniyellu kaliyona, kalikeya hosa hadiyali, jotegudi hecheya hakona, santasadi kaliyona, namma. ಹೆಮ್ಮೆಯಾಯಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿನಲ್ಲಿ.
ಯೆಸ್ ಸರ್.
ಯೆಸ್ ಟೀಚರ್. ದ ಸೇಮ್ ಮ್ಯಾಮ್.